Hi everybody, it's Sean. This next video that I wanted to do is called image cropping. I realize that a lot of the images that we use in layouts, we tend to take for granted the image is the image, and we use the image and then we lay out around it or beside it. So I thought it's probably worth talking about image cropping and seeing how the crop of an image can make a difference in what happens in your layout. Okay, so the images that I'm using for this tutorial have been given to me with permission by my good friend and photographer, Anthony Taylor. And he's generously given me a whack of images to use for this, so I've picked some good ones that I thought were purposeful. So this model is, of course, an attractive looking model, and this is a very nice shot and nice expression on her face. So this image as it stands without any cropping is pleasant to begin with. So, on this page, I'm going to show you some different cropping options. And in the case of coming in really close, because her expression is relatively soft, you can come in close, but you can see what's happening here is that it looks like she doesn't have the top of her head. So you should kind of be careful about things like that. And I'd be tempted possibly to increase this cropping a little bit, but even the higher I go up, it tends to look like she's bald. So I could come in tighter to eliminate that problem. So just be aware of that as you crop images. If you want to come in close for a facial expression like this, just be careful to look for things that may create odd relationships between the image and its crop. In the case of coming in close to the eyes, in this one, because her eyes aren't really, really expressive in the shot, they're relatively calm in expression, nothing wrong with that. But I find that this kind of crop doesn't tell me enough of a story. I don't really see what's happening in her expression. I need the whole thing. And this expression could be about beauty, it could be about well-being and those things, but there's not enough intensity, at least I don't think. You can have a different opinion, but in my opinion, the intensity of the eyes might be important. Another kind of crop is to come in and crop half of the image out, particularly in a face. You need symmetry for this, and I'll show you some examples shortly where this doesn't exist, and that creates a bit of a problem. So this is the right side of her face, right side from a camera's point of view. But if I crop to the left side, you can see that it's entirely different. Everyone's face has two different sides, of course, and those different sides look different, and even in the most symmetrical featured models, the two sides are different. So when you're going to try something like this, be aware of the facial features themselves and what side that model may or may not tend towards. Just important to think about. So this next image of the same model is a different expression. It's a similar photograph in that it's kind of a neutral background and she's relatively symmetrical on camera, but her expression is quite different. Let's see what happens in some of the same kinds of situations. In this one, for example, because her eyes have that slight intensity to them, this works for me. Suddenly now there's an opportunity to come in close to the eyes because they do tell a bit of a story. But they could have a come hither look, or they could have a don't mess with me look. Right? There's that subtle difference between those two things, for example. So your message in your layout could have a lot to do with how that plays out. Coming in close to her facial expression is perfectly fine here, and I've shown enough of her hairline as to get away from those strange shapes you can get in a face. And similarly, when I divide the face in half with her, one half of her face doesn't work so well. The other half works really well. And it happens to be the same half in both cases that works well. This kind of a thing works with most images, but it works here too. But this image and this image have some really interesting possibilities just because of her expression. So the same model once again, I just wanted to show you now because this model isn't quite symmetrical. That head tilt sort of adds up. So I wanted to kind of show how that can play out. So in this case, I've avoided going into the eyes because her eyes aren't straight across. Now I could rotate them, but because of the tilt of her head, I've just decided to not worry about that kind of a cropping option for this image. But you can see that it could work nicely for a banner or something wide. Kind of works out okay. However, half the face, that symmetrical half and half cropping that we do, this doesn't work so well. But it's because of the rotation of her head, and that image isn't necessarily meant to be symmetrical. However, I could decide, let's just say that I want to rotate her into symmetry. Maybe I get away with that, and maybe that shot works out okay. But you have to decide that on a shot-by-shot basis. So coming into the eyes, as I was saying before, I avoided this just because I didn't feel that this shot had necessarily the strength for that. So this other model, her pose is obviously much less symmetrical, and her body is less towards camera. So now we have two different angles. We have the angle of her expression and the angle of her body. Those will create different situations for us. So if I come in close to her eyes here, the problem that I have with this kind of crop is that though she's an attractive woman, now that I come in, I begin to see the imbalances in maybe her facial structure. One of her eyes looks a little bit bigger than the other, and the angle of her eyes and expression are a little bit off in this, and I don't think that rotating this image would get it done. So you have to look for the shapes of the models and find out what, if you want to isolate certain features. It may be that a different photograph of the same girl might work okay, but this one doesn't so much. However, it does stand up okay for more of a quirky crop. So then the line of her body becomes the interesting thing of the shot, and that may, you know, work for your layout. Another kind of quirky crop that this one works okay for, and coming into a half crop, as we had talked about before, really, you know, in either case does not work well, because again, not that she and her face aren't okay, but because of the rotation of her expression, because of the angle of her head, you get into strange shapes where half of the image seems to describe somebody who looks odd. If you have trouble imagining what the other half looks like. So you want to look out for accidental misshapen kinds of things that can be brought on by, you know, a round cheekbone or just the position of the person's expression and body. So be aware of those things when you're choosing images. Same model once again, and she's sending some texts. So what happens, what are the possibilities here? Well, the one thing that I wanted to show you to be careful of is if you wanted to come in tight because you like the shot but you didn't need the cell phone, that you have to be careful that you have basically what I call missing or fragmented body parts. So you've got her arms in the bottom left, and because you don't know she's holding a cell phone, you might guess she is. You could guess that maybe it's a book, maybe she's eating something. But without context, it looks kind of odd. And so I'm a fan of kind of avoiding those types of situations. However, you could come in close because she's looking down, and when you eliminate the fact that there is something in her hands, then suddenly her expression, what is she looking at? Is she thinking about something? She seems happy, or is it a romantic thought? So you can kind of persuade people to see it your way as long as you give it context. It can also stand a nice sort of medium crop in this case. Again, as long as you remove the hands that appear to be trying to do something, but not showing that whole thing. You can play around a bit, but just be aware of those things. Kind of pay attention to what your images are doing is the point. So this next shot is an extreme expression. So I wanted to kind of show you what happens with expressions like this. They can be tricky to work with. So even though this is a very pleasant photograph, she's very cute and she's obviously happy, that this can present some problems if you're not careful in your cropping. For example, if you come into just the eyes on this one, the problem that you have is that this can be, well, it's okay, it's a problem, but it's also possibly a solution for you. The eyes alone in a laugh are very similar to the eyes in somebody crying or screaming. So, I mean, she doesn't look like she's in anguish here, but you can see that it's borderline. If I had showed you this image before showing her smiling, you might not be certain which way it goes. Now, similarly with the mouth, without the expression of the eyes and the whole context, I think that you see it's a happy expression. But you stop sort of seeing the smile and the laugh as pleasant. You begin to focus on, you know, the shape of her teeth and her lips. And all those things are fine, but they may not tell the story that you're going for. For me, coming in on the face like this, eliminating a lot of the background, you still have context. You don't need a lot of other things beyond this expression, but just in a case like this, I might avoid coming in so close that, you know, you start to create strange shapes. So leave enough so that you understand, oh, well, this is the border of her face and there's hair, etc. I think it's good to give these things context. And in the case of the half and half split photo, this is a photo by photo basis. I mean, I think potentially this image might be more interesting than this one, just because, again, that facial symmetry and one side looks different than the other side. So you could probably get away with that one. This one, I'm not so sure, but that's really your opinion, your taste based on images that you have to work with. You can make those decisions as you go. A few more images. This one, I wanted to get into body postures because these ones are tricky to crop. My favorite way to crop these images is almost not at all. The best thing in the case of an extreme or dynamic pose is to show that whole pose. And the reason I like to do that is because as soon as you start removing things, then it can get kind of awkward. Like in the case of this smaller crop, her shoulders are rotated forward and her head is turned. You could gather that that's because her shoulders have been rolled up and she's probably in some kind of position like this one, but you can't see the whole position. So all you really get is this kind of extreme grin with just the shoulders without sort of the overall shot here, which kind of gives you that, oh, she's obviously doing a cute, fun pose and there's some purpose to that. This one just sort of doesn't give you all that stuff. And I find that her expression alone, out of the context of the whole pose, looks a bit odd to me. Like, I don't know why somebody would have that look on their face. Similarly, I have a bit of a problem with cutting off half of the body. I mean, this tells you more of the story, and that's fine. But sort of you get the idea that her butt is probably sticking out, but you don't see it all. It just seems strange to me. But you could, as long as you open up the shot a little more, you may like this, in which case, that's all fine. Just for me, the more you give context, the better. But I still don't think that's enough, and that's just my personal opinion. And of course, if you have to crop into a very tight space, showing at least the body line kind of helps you. I don't think this is great, as is the case in this one. I don't think that's great either. But you could, in a case like this, you could sort of get away with having that much of the body. And to kind of just take it a step further, I'm going to give these a stroke just so... you know, if you want to imagine that these were web banners or something like that, then you can kind of see the cropping with a context of a frame works a little bit better. This one, not so much for me. If I had to come in tight, I'd rather come in this way, take off enough that at least I leave the center line relatively undisturbed. So this next shot, same model, because her pose is much more dynamic, in this case, it's a flat out jumping flexing kind of move as a dancer might do. These ones, I wanted to show you the pitfalls of cropping images like this. Now, granted, these are extreme examples. I realize not every layout you do is going to have something like this to deal with, but it's good to talk about it, I think. So this is kind of the full crop, once again, but I've just expanded it and removed the background. So this tells you the whole story. It's a leap. She's obviously flexing and dancing. It's not something else. If I take out a part of that, however, this suddenly looks like she's been punched in the face, you know, and she's reeling backwards. Without the context of her body, it seems now more painful and somehow like she's been attacked, which is just a strange thing. Similarly, if I start taking off parts of the image because I wanted to show a narrow crop in this way, the problem is now I'm getting into body parts again. Why does she only have a quarter of a leg? What happened? Because you're not getting the other leg to tell you the story that, oh no, she has two legs and she's jumping and cranking her legs back in this big leap. You don't have that context. And similarly here, the random strange flying body parts. Is this another person? Is that a foot? Is this, you know, is that a pair of pants or what is it? You know, it gets harder to understand. It could almost look like this is all part of her arm and that's her hand and she's holding the bottom of a pant leg. It just seems strange. You want to be careful of the random parts of bodies that don't have a story. And similarly here, you know, again, broken body parts. So the point is, I realize these are all kind of the same problem, but the point is, look at what you're cropping and be very careful about what images you use in the space that you have, because they can get weird. And even in this case, with a border, it's not going to help a lot. Because even with that border, it may give them containment, but it still doesn't give them context. And the last image that I wanted to show you was this image, which is similar to the previous ones. I wanted to show you similar problems, but of course she's not dancing or leaping. There's no strange pose that she's in. However, context is still important. Now, if I come into her eyes, because I'd be tempted to, because her eyes have expression, the problem I have to look for are, again, random body parts. Here's a part of her hand, and in the context of the whole shot, I understand what that is. In this context, I don't. So I could solve that problem simply by coming in. This crop here is strange because I'm not giving you enough of the story to know what her hands are on. So even though I've pulled back and I've shown you that, okay, if you start doing the math, you figure this is probably her arm over here, but it's not 100% clear. And, you know, it's bent, but why is it bent? Is she holding something? Is she grabbing something? Or is she keeping something from hitting her in the head? And is this her hand again? Is the same problem? You know, you can come in tighter, but as long as you just have enough on the left side here, her arm, now suddenly her arm is obviously connected to her body. I don't need to show you the whole hat. You just need to see that she's holding the rim. That helps you understand. Oh, wait, it's her arm. She's holding the rim. Okay, got you. She's putting on a hat. And then suddenly this fragment of a hand makes sense. And all these things together make sense. But sometimes these strange isolated crops don't give you enough of the story and it becomes hard to understand. Drop me a note if you have any comments or you have a difference of opinion, as always. Always good to hear what other people think, and it can be different than what I think, by all means. And I would love to get your feedback. That's it for today. Thanks for watching.